it is so addicting. Got my mic. I had to wait for our maintenance guy to leave. As soon as I launched up the game, they called me and said, "Hey, we're sending him up." I didn't want the poor guy looking at me strange like I'm talking to myself. Birds with one stone by getting some experience and leveling up ship talents. I've done pretty much all of the faction quests so far in this game, in this playthrough. A bunch of miscellaneous stuff, and now I'm just kind of leveling up, having fun, getting talents before I go to New Game Plus again. Start it all over. Perfecting this ship I have right now. even touched the outpost aspect of this game, which is crazy intricate too, because you can link outposts. Yes, it's probably my favorite ship I've ever built. My first custom ship. And like I said, I'm just farming space counters so I can get my talents up. This ship probably took me 5-ish hours, and coming back to it several days in a row to adjust stuff or change things. And it probably cost me almost 1 million credits. I'm eventually going to do kind of a step-by-step how-to of how I made this ship. But my favorite thing about it is on the inside, there are no ladders. So no up and down. Climbing up ladders or jetpacking up the holes. It's all uniform. My cockpit has stairs, so it's got 2 levels, but no ladders. Then there are actually hubs on the wings that you can enter.
Thank you.
chains of work keeping us from what we want to do, right? To the work. I just really don't want to go. Buff fell off. Oh, hello, Vasco. See, you're just hanging around. And Andrea is sleeping cloaked. Adria.
All systems looking good, boss.
She's in my bed.
Hi.
down.
Always a pleasure, Captain.
You keep installing new cool things.
So this one learn more is next time. In one of the wings. See? Oh, hi, kitty. And then across this way. You can see out the back. Here is the other wing. Got windows. This has got a research lab and stuff like that in there. There's a window, seeing that wing over there.
Mm-hmm. Ready for
this
action,
is just
Captain.
A control station. And then here's another crew area.
Never mind.
The control station.
Sorry.
And that way leads up to
thinking
the cockpit.
Something else. Yes, Captain.
And then over here I have all of my workbenches. A pharmaceutical lab, which has more research and the pharmaceutical stuff.
Captain on deck?
Hello.
And then you come up here to the cockpit.
You
this is my favorite cockpit. The window view from it is just amazing. Then back here is my captain's quarters. And then we've got the armory. I don't have anything set up in it yet, because every time you change your ship, it all goes into the cargo hold. But I think I'm done fiddling with it for now, so I may put my stuff there. And then right here is the exit docker. And then down at the bottom is where the landing
Hello,
bay
Captain.
Is, where you enter the ship from the ground. So you enter right here and can go straight to the cockpit. Yes, this cockpit is just amazing. And I love the stairs that go up. I probably would. Seems like a pretty comfy ship to hang out in. any opportunity to show it off. Whenever I'm in space, it's always there. Right now, I want to say it's the shipbuilding because that's where I spend a good chunk of my time. But I really love the stories too. Every single quest line I've done has been in depth and fleshed out, and it feels fun. The Raijin faction questline is probably my favorite questline I've done. The corporate espionage and intrigue is so awesome. This is one of the best places to get space battles, because it seems like almost every planet or moon you travel to has these Varun ambushers, and they're a pretty decent level too. Like, I've gotten into some spicy battles here. High-level enemy ships. But you just get so much experience from doing it. Like, I'm pretty sure I'm about to hit level 80. Yep, I'm almost there. Travel to a different one. there's another kind of experience farm where you can create outposts and set up like animal farms and just gun down animals. And I'd wager it's probably a little bit quicker than doing it this way. But that way you just so much ammo. And ammo is definitely harder to get in this game. Even worse because they're these like alien wolf like looking things that are really cool. But then this way, you also get credits and ship parts and resources for looting the ships. But I mean, you don't need to loot the ships if you don't want to. You can make this a lot faster by just killing them, jumping to the next moon, killing them, jumping to the next moon. Without wasting the time to go loot them. But I think looting them is really you need all the credits you can get in this game.
Hey Dad? Will you meet me tonight, Ruben?
Me too, sure.
Prepare to place judgment.
Mass Effect is probably the only game I have more playtime in than Skyrim. Or, like, at the level of Skyrim. Comfort game. When I don't know what to play or just not in the mood for anything specific, just load up Skyrim, spend about 3 hours updating your mods, setting your LO, and then you can play. Plus IO score before the new season. But I just don't feel like playing it. It's definitely challenging. There's a lot going on that you have to learn, and it requires a lot of research. And as any MMO is, it is super time consuming. Because I haven't played for like 2 weeks or barely played it at all, I am falling very far behind. I've been playing World of Warcraft for a very, very long time. High-end player. We're kind of a very casual group. We just kind of play and have fun. Yeah, I definitely understand that. I am a lot more casual. I don't like playing player versus player games. That just stresses me out. Occasionally with my husband and some of our other friends, but I don't feel like I'm there about it. I always feel like they end up just carrying me through games, or I pull the team down. Recently, though, I've been challenging myself, and I've been replaying the Mass Effect games on Legendary, and I've already completed 1 and 2 on Legendary, and like halfway through number 3. believe me, the amount of times that I have died over and over and over while doing it, it's more a matter of persistence than skill. My kids will sit there and watch, and they'll be like, "You died again? Oh my gosh." Yeah, and sometimes it'll take me like 2-3 hours just to get through one major mission. Yep. Die so many times, I know what the AI is gonna do before they do it.
Last night, well, all that physical training seems to have paid off.
I have not actually, but I'm.
Confess,
I want to. I watch this guy on a Twitch who streams it. Yeah, just watching him for makes me want to try it, but I've never tried. I think it's on Game Pass.
Thank you.
I tried playing a different survival game once, I think. Ark. And when it just kind of threw me into a random place and then just set me loose and I had no idea what I was doing, I only played for like maybe an hour. Beyond that, I don't have any experience in survival games. I don't even play Skyrim on survival games. Say that maybe I'll give DayZ a chance since it is on Game Pass, but I'd probably be lying to myself since I can't stop playing this game. I like watching it, and I don't know if it's just the streamer in general, how he makes it look, or just the encounters that he has, but I like watching it for sure.
Thank you.
Yes, he always has some crazy encounters with other people.
Powering jump drive.
And it just makes me
fully restored.
Laugh seeing the weird situations that they all get into. Though sometimes it's a good thing, like when Starfield first came out, I ended up watching my husband play for like all day long, and then when it was finally, I was able to avoid some of the mistakes that he made. Like, this is all I've done for almost an hour now. And, you know, I'm not even bored of it. Probably. Once I hit the next level, I'll go, do some quests and stuff just to kind of mix it up a little bit, but I could just do space battles for hours. Incredible time sink. Because I've watched my husband build up his outpost network, and that took him hours just to get set up. Say that flashing means I'm about to get jumped by a starborn. Ships while in targeting mode. Means I've actually I should be anyways. It really helps. Stuff while I'm working.
Just
target them. Oh, we got some. Typically stream when I play in the morning around this time, pretty much every day during the week. On the weekends, when it is like a current raid tier, I'll stream World of Warcraft and my guild's raids, but we're not raiding right now, so I haven't been streaming that because there's nothing to stream. My streams, I will upload onto YouTube. Same name as Twitch, just Kugia. Thank you.
feared the Great Serpent himself may have needed to avert his eyes at some of what went on last night.
It's good to be out and about. Lodge gets stuffy sometimes.
Yes. One thing you can always count on in Bethesda games is that's weird. Weird stuff. Then I got Vasco just glitched in the ceiling. Hey, I aim to impress.
Jump capability.
I'm trying to target them before I kill them so I can get the credit for that. But they keep dying before my targeting critical fills up. See, I'm trying to do this. I've got 13. I've definitely killed more than 13 ships. But they keep dying before I can actually target them. Two of them with targeting that time. That all knocked out my weapon systems. I really like it when those guys jump me, because they give a ton of experience.
Halfway there.
rock in my way. A lot of credits doing this.
Ground is down.
will make ship battles even easier. When you boost, they lose target of you.
Thank you.
worse ways to begin a day than here with you.
How many more do I need? 6. So, 4 more targeted kills. Still farming. I need 4 more kills with targets.
Station, Captain.
Yes, just four more. Now three more. One more. I like Nightbot. I actually only just figured out how to get it set up recently. I just need to level up, then I will have 4-4 there, 4-4 here, 4-4 here, 4-4 here, 4-4 here, and 4-4 there. These are all the important ship talents that I need. And then maybe this one for my lasers. And then payloads, probably. But that one would be helpful. Do a few more battles just because I'm almost leveled up, and then we'll go do some quests. Then once you finish the story, you can go into New Game Plus, which is basically just resetting the whole game. You leave everything behind, your gear, your credits, your ships, your weapons, everything behind in the old game, and you start fresh at a new game. But you keep any of the powers that you found, all your levels and your talent points, and then you can just play the game again. And as far as I know, there is not a level cap. You can just level up indefinitely. Yeah, essentially, while there is a technical ending, it does just go on forever.
You would think that deadly predators would have driven off settlers. Humans. We can be so stubborn.
Yes.
Lord of Raids are coming soon. No time to talk.
Well, there's no reason to rush, you know. it's one of those games where you can do it at your own pace. You know, I had intentions just to...
We're asking, hey, what can I do for you?
Rush
okay,
through
sure.
this.
We'll take care of any holes, broken seals,
and
that kind of thing.
Go into another New Game Plus. But instead of doing that, I've ended up doing everything else in this game. I've done all the factions. I've
been up there, huh?
I know, you know, rather well. Perhaps better than I would like.
Got sidetracked and started doing stuff.
Take a gander.
Now I get to play the, fun commerce game for a little bit. Buy stuff, sell stuff, buy stuff, sell stuff.
You ask me? Travel? I'm sure I got what you need.
Now, from this person right here, I'll tell you a little secret. She sells if it'll finish loading, she sells this blue pistol called Elegance. And it's probably one of the best pistols you can get. I froze. I know, right? It happens, though. We'll have to see where my autosave ended up. Yes, I froze. Didn't lose too much there. Selling some stuff, buying some stuff.
I would not mind stopping at the Laredo storefront. I appreciate their craftsmanship.
Looking for
stuff.
Sure, Laredo makes them. Okay.
I just
start shooting up the town with
board my resources. But since I'm not really using them in this playthrough, I haven't really bothered with that.
My manor in the core has been approved by both the mayor and the historical committee. Not strictly necessary, but it means you can buy it with a clean conscience. Nice to meet you. I'm Mr. Tate, and you, welcome to Aquila City. If so, then look no. Oh, where are my manners? Very sorry. I hope my insensitive assumptions don't turn you away from considering my properties. I have two properties for sale. This one here is a refurbished colonial manor in the heart of the core. I also have a more modest one bedroom in Midtown. Any interest in them? It's my favorite listing I've had in years. spacious, in the core itself. I took great pains to get all the approvals, so the neighbors should be no problem. It's historic and spacious. Oh my, so much space. And the price is a veritable bargain. You have made my year with this. I just know this manor will bring you nothing except joy and good fortune. It's yours.
I'm a proud homeowner now. Sold a whole bunch of my resources, so I probably can't build anything. On the bedroom. This is nice. Yes, you can do the same thing inside your outpost too. You can set it all up. You know, however you want to do it. See what else we have. We can put some pictures on the wall. Thank you. need to get more resources. Boards in here too. Yeah.
night was enlightening. I hope to learn more next time.
Unfortunately, it is time for me to go do adult stuff. I know, right? I love that. But thank you for joining and watching. I definitely plan to pick this up again tomorrow. Yeah.